Hello friends, next topic is conversion of finite automata to regular expression. As we already discussed about what is regular expression and how we convert some regular expression to finite automata in our previous video. Now with the help of one method called as a state creation method, we convert some finite automata to a regular expression. So first we discuss what is a state creation method. State elimination method. So with the help of this method, we convert some finite automata to regular expression. So there are four rules in this method. The rule one says that there is no incoming edge to initial state, and if there is an incoming edge to the initial state, so in that case, we create a new initial state. For example, if I have a finite automata like this, this is the state A and this is the state B. And in this case, see here, A is the final state and from B, there is an incoming edge to A. So in that case, we create a new initial state. Like this, if this is a A state, this is a B state. So in the earlier case, A is the final state. Now to remove this condition, we create another state which is known as a QS, or you can name it anything, and this QS becomes the initial state, and here from QS to A we take an input epsilon. So in this case, we remove this condition that there is no incoming edge to the initial state. Okay. Now the rule 2. Rule 2 say that there is no outgoing edge. There is no outgoing edge to the final state. Okay. So if this is so, then we create new, or we remove this condition by creating a new final state by an epsilon move. How? Like this. For example, if this is the initial state A, if this is the final state B, and we have an outgoing edge like C, we have an outgoing edge from this B state, which is the final state. So to remove this, we create a new state, means A, B, and C, and from the previous B state, which is the final state, we create a new state by an epsilon move like this, for example, D. Okay. So this is how we remove second condition. The third condition say that there is only one final state. If we have a finite automata in which we have a more than one final state, so we remove all those final state by taking one final state by an epsilon move like this. For example, if we have this finite automata, we have more than one final state like this. Then to remove these three final state, we replace these three final state by a single final state. And from this previous final state, we take the epsilon move to the new final state like this. If this is the initial state, if this is a state, these are the some final state. Sorry, okay. We draw again. If this is the initial state, if this is another state, for example, A, B, here I name it as A, B, C, D, and E. So from this C state, D state, means first we create the final state as non-final, and we add one new state called as F, which will become a new initial final state, and we by an epsilon move. So in before, this finite automata have three final state, now it contain only one final state. And the rule 4, last rule, says that other than other than initial and final state, other than initial and final state, eliminate other state one by one. Other state one by one. For example, see here A, B, C, D, E, F. In this finite automata, A is the initial state and F is the final state. So, the rule 4 say that other than these two state, initial and final state, eliminate all other state. For example, B, C, D and E, eliminate all these three, four state one by one. Okay. So, there are four rules in the state elimination method. Now, we use these four rules for conversion of finite automata to a regular expression. So, we take first example that if this is a finite automata like this, A, B and C, and A, capital A and capital B are two states where A is the initial and B is the final state. Now, we have to convert this finite automata into a regular expression. So, which rule follow this finite automata? That is rule 4, that other than the initial and the final state, okay, or we can say if there are three edges between initial and the final state, so we replace all these three edges by one edge, and by like this, if this is a final, so we replace all these three edges by only a one edge, and by taking as input A, B, C, and for this automata in the fine building block, I already give take an example. We represent this finite automata by A plus B plus C as a regular expression. Okay, now we take another example like this. Next question is, if this is an initial state, we have an input A, then input B, and then we have another state. For example, we have a state A, state B and state C. In this case, see, the rule 4 follow that other than the initial and the final state A and C, I have to eliminate this state B. Okay, how we eliminate this? That, see here, we have to keep A as it is, we have to keep A as it is as an initial state, B as it is as a final state, C as a final state. So what which state we have to remove? B. So see here, from A to C, while moving from A to C, we have a state B. If I remove this, then what input is travel from A to C? That A and B. So we take it as A, B, or A comma B. So how we write it, A comma B, in a regular expression like A plus B. So the rule 4 says that other than the initial and the final state, we remove other states. In this case, we remove B, and after removing B, what we get as a regular expression, that is A plus B. Okay, now we take another example. If I take example like this, if this is a state A, state B and state C, and if I have input small a, small b and small c, then how we get the regular expression for this finite automata? First we see that in this finite automata, the rule 4 follows, so other than the A state and C state, we have to eliminate state B. Okay, how we do this? As like previous question, means we take A as the A state as like this in question, we take C as a final state. Okay, so if I remove B here, see, on B state there is an input B which travels any number of time, and we represent it in any number of time by an asterisk sign. Okay, and if I travel from A to C, What are the inputs? A, B any number of time, and then C. So it will look like this. A, B asterisk, then C. Then this is the case. Okay, so this is the regular expression. Now we take more example in which other rules also follow. For example, if I have a finite automata like this A, B, from A to B we have an input 0 and from B we have an input 1. Now in this case, see here, we have a incoming edge, this incoming edge to the initial state, and we also have a outgoing edge from B state. So rule 1 and rule 2 both apply to this question. So we have to eliminate an incoming edge to initial state and outgoing edge from a final state by creating a new initial state. So the first step is, if A and B same, or we can say, or we can draw like this, if A is the state, B is an another state. Now for removing the rule 1, that there is no incoming edge to an initial state, so we create a new initial state called as QS and mark it as initial state, and from B there is an incoming edge to H, and from QS to A we have an epsilon move. C, here we take it as 0, and now for here, for removing this B as a final state, we create a new final state which we represented as QF by an epsilon move. So the rule 1 and rule 2 apply fully. Now for converting this finite automata to a regular expression, the rule 4 apply. That is, other than this initial state and the final state, I have to remove these two states, which is known as A and B, one by one. Okay. First, if I eliminate state A, so see here, from this QS, we have an input 0 to B, as well as we have an input from B to A, then B, with a input 1 and 0 with any number of times. So if I eliminate A, now the finite automata look like this. QS is the initial state, B as a state, other state, and QF is the initial final state, which we have a epsilon move. Now for removing this A state, from QS to B, we have a input 0, and from B to, again from B to A, then B, we have a loop having an input 1 and 0 with any number of times. So we represent it like this, 1 and 0 asterisk. Okay, then if I eliminate state B here, see here, if I eliminate, other than these two states, if I eliminate this B here, what we get? QS as an initial state, QF as a final state, and in between this QN and QF, what the input? What is the input? 0 followed by 1 and 0 asterisk. 0, 1 and 0 followed by asterisk. So this is the final answer. Okay. Now the last example for this for the conversion is, we take another example. If I have a finite automata like this, A, B, C, from B, A to B we have an input A, from B to A I have an input B, from here we have a C, and from B to C we have an input D. Now I have to convert this finite automata to a regular expression by state elimination method. Now if I see here that other than this initial state and final state, I have a one more state, that is called B. So I have to eliminate this. So how we get this? So step one say, or there is one, there are two rule, or rule one and rule two also apply, that there is an incoming edge to an initial state and there is an outgoing edge from the, there is an incoming edge to this initial state, and other than the initial and the final state, we have an one more state, that is B, that so that we have to eliminate this. So if I rule apply, if I apply rule 1, then here we get one initial, one new state, which is called a QS, which is an initial state, and from QS to A we have a silent move. Okay, from B to C it remain same, and from C we have a this. So in step 1 we apply rule 1, that is there is no incoming edge to the initial state. Now if I see here that other than the initial and the final state, we have two other states A and B, so have to eliminate these two states one by one. Okay, so first if I eliminate this state A, eliminate state A, then what we get? QS as a initial state. Okay, here C as a final state. B state remains same. From B to C we have a input D. Now from this initial state we have a input to B is that epsilon followed by B. So epsilon followed by B is B as B here. Now from B to A, then A to B, we have a input AB any number of times. Okay. Or we state as like this AB as any number of time, and B is also have an input like C here, which represents C as any number of time. If I combine these input, these two input on B, I will represent it as QS B C here. This is D, remains same B, and now this I combine C and AB. So what we get? C plus AB whole asterisk. Okay. Now the last state, we eliminate state B. So the final answer we get, that QS C. Now from QS to C, what we get? B is followed by C plus AB whole asterisk and followed by D. So this is your final answer. B is followed by C plus AB whole asterisk and then followed by D. So these are all some examples that how we convert finite automata to a regular expression by a state elimination method. Okay. So if you have any doubt, then you can ask in our comment section. And if you like our video, then please subscribe our channel. Thanks for watching.